What's up, guys? Welcome to Week 17 NFL Picks with Tanner Kern, a.k.a. the betting guy here at bparlay, a.k.a. the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. We are rolling here at bparlay.com. The Army is going to war every single day against the sportsbooks, and you know who's coming out on top? The freaking bparlay Army. I'm seeing comments in the comments section saying, hey, I want to be a general. I am a general in the bparlay. I want to be a sergeant. I want to be a soldier in the bparlay Army. The bparlay Army is growing day by day by day, and you know why? Because we're winning a lot here at the channel. Let's keep it going this week. 12-4 against the spread in Week 16. Does it get any better than that? Yes, it does. Here's why. This winning is sustained. Greatness, championships, winning, sustained over a long period of time. 42-17-1 against the spread in the past 4 weeks. Are we feeling good yet? Are we feeling good? Are we satisfied? How's the bellies feeling? Are you full? No. We're always starving here for greatness at bparlay. We are starving for greatness. We win on Thursday, even though there's no Thursday night football this week. It's a mentality, it's a mindset. It's never going to leave bparlay. We win on Thursday, we win more on Sunday, and then we clean up on Monday, baby. Let's go to work. Now, I'm wearing a ref shirt today. I want to start with this. Why am I wearing a ref shirt? Now, as you guys know, I did pretty well last week, 12-4 against the spread. But anyways, I took the under on Dak Prescott's throwing total. I do lose a little bit. I'm not going to say I don't. I do lose a little bit. Now, the chirpers come in the comment section saying, Tanner, you don't hit parlays. You don't hit parlays. Yeah, who freaking who? Comment. I love it. Because you know what? I'm not a good guy. I'm not a bad guy. I'm the guy. Anyway, I'm wearing the ref shirt today. Why am I wearing the ref shirt? Show off the guns a little bit. Hey, now. Hey, now. Don't let the boys get hot too late anyways. Why am I wearing the ref shirt? I'm watching the Dallas Cowboys game this week. Now, Dak Prescott had a sensational day, not as good as Joey Burrow. Joey Burrow threw for about 10,000 yards this weekend. But anyways, I'm watching Dak, and Dak hit his throwing total in the first half. So there goes my under bet on his throwing total. But anyways, there was a point in the game when, obviously, the game just started, so he didn't have that many yards. Now, he started like 15 to 15, so he got it pretty quickly. But I'm watching this game, and there's a lineman for the Dallas Cowboys about 30 yards down the field on one of Dak's completed passes. Now, did the ref think a 300-pound mauler was a receiver? I don't know. So you know what? They did not throw a flag on that, and that cost me money. That's a play that cost me money, because maybe, you know what? They don't complete that pass. Maybe Dak falls out of his rhythm a little bit, and maybe my bet hits. I don't know. But the NFL needs new refs, and I'm here to do it because we're winning machines at bparlay. The bparlay Army can do whatever the hell they want. That's what I will say that. So you know what? Hell, I'll go ref an NFL game. Why not? Why not? That's why I got the ref shirt on today. We're rocking. We're rolling here at the channel, ready to make some money. Now, got to get myself a free shout out. Of course, follow me on social at Tanner Kern on IG, at Tanner Kern _ on Twitter, and hammer the subscribe button. Hammer it, hammer it, hammer it. Because you know what? Half the people that watch these videos are not subscribed, and that's a problem, guys. We need to get that going. We're at 2.6 1,000, I believe, right now. We're going to the freaking moon every day. The Army gets bigger and bigger by the second because all we do is win here at the channel. And you know what? If you don't want to be part of the Army and just want to comment, chirp, 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 go ahead, comment. Go ahead, comment, and say, you know what? Who wants to be part of the Army? Everyone wants to be part of the Army. And if you don't want to be part of the Army, you're not cool. That's what I'll say to that. Let's get into the quote here. Actually, I got one more announcement. One more announcement. Now, I'm on SharpRank. This is for, like, betting media, personalities, blah, blah, blah. I'm the number 11 ranked NFL bettor on the platform. Number 11. This platform has ESPN, Fox Sports, NBC, Athlon Sports, The Athletic, all these different media outlets. You know who's the number 11th ranked NFL bettor on SharpRank? Tanner freaking Kern, bparlay. Let's go to work. Just throw that in there. You can go follow me on there as well. Download the app. Shout out SharpRank. All right, here's the quote. Anyone know what I'm doing? Wolf of Wall Street, baby. Jordan Belfort. You can watch me, mock me, and try to block me, but you cannot stop me. This is the perfect quote for the bparlay Army. Here's why. The bparlay Army doesn't stop. It's like a freaking machine that doesn't stop. We go to war every single day against the sportsbooks. Every single day of the week. And you know what? It's not stopping right now. We have 32 regular season NFL games remaining on the betting slate. And I'll tell you for damn sure, we're going to war for all 32 of them. And we're going to come on out on top. That's the mentality. It's the mindset. It's never going to leave bparlay. Let's go to work. Hammer the subscribe button like you're going to hammer the Buffalo Bills at -14.5 on Sunday. Now, no Thursday night football, as I said before. We got 15 games on Sunday. One on Monday, and then next week they're all on Sunday, so let's enjoy it. All right, the Atlanta Falcons are not good at football. That's what you got to know in this game. The Atlanta Falcons are very bad at football. I would say the Buffalo Bills are back because they're going to win the AFC East, but I always expected them to win the AFC East. I didn't expect the Patriots to be as good as they were. I'm probably going to lose money on my Patriots Super Bowl bet. But from the beginning of the season, I thought Buffalo was going to win the AFC East. We all did. Now, Atlanta's not good. They did beat the Lions, but they were unable to cover against the Lions last week. Good teams win. Great teams cover. We know the narrative, guys. That's all you need to know in this game. Buffalo minus 14.5. I hate laying the spread, but it's at home. It's in Orchard Park. You got to go with it. Now we'll go Giants-Bears. The Bears screwed our parlay last week. The Bears screwed it. You know what? Seattle fell apart late. Chicago comes back, wins the game, blah, blah, blah. I don't care. But New York can't protect the quarterback this week. I hate betting the Bears. I really do. As you saw last week, I didn't take them. But they're going to get to the quarterback this week. The New York Giants are terrible. They're not in good shape. They're really bad at football. Now, the Bears are at home this week. Bears minus 6, easy money. I love the spread. Justin Fields makes a lot of rookie mistakes, but I still love the spread. The Giants need to figure out a new solution. They need to get better at football, really. I don't know what it's going to take of them, but they need to get better. Then we got Chiefs-Bengals. This is probably one of the best games on the slate this week. I still think the spread is very, very juicy. You got the minus 5.5 in favor of the Chiefs. Now they're on the road. They're in Cincinnati. Joe Burrow threw for about 500-something yards. I know I said 10,000 earlier. He threw for a lot of yardage. I don't think he has the success against the Chiefs secondary. The Chiefs are pretty damn good on defense. They're getting better and better and better. They have not lost in a long time. They whooped the Steelers' ass last week. That was a game where Pittsburgh just didn't show up. We'll talk about that a little later. But that was embarrassing. I got to go with the hot hand here. It's the Chiefs at minus 5.5. Yes, the Bengals are coming off a great performance, but they've been so inconsistent. There's a few teams I don't like to bet, the Bengals and the Chiefs. Now I'm going to bet the Bengals and the Chargers. I mean, I'm going to bet the Chargers again this week, but you know what? We'll save that for another time. I like the Bengals to lose this game at home. Chiefs to cover. Go Chiefs. Dolphins-Titans. Dolphins have won 7 straight games. It's hard to argue with that. I did take the Titans last week at plus 3.5. When you look at the Titans, though, they're not a bad football team. They're not as good as they were with Derrick Henry, obviously. But if you turn the ball over, Tennessee will make you pay. We saw what Jimmy G had a Titans money line last week. That's what it came down to. He was horrendous. Some of the passes he threw were just terrible. It looked like he legitimately had Titans money line last week. So Dolphins have won 7 straight games. They looked good last night. So I'm going to go with them. Hard to argue with 7 straight wins. They make it 8 this week. And you know what? At plus 3.5, you got the hook there. You're protected. They can lose by 3 points and the bet still hits. Go with them at plus 3.5. Take the points. I know they're on the road, but still go with it. Raiders Colts here. Now the Colts beat up the Cardinals. The Colts absolutely beat up the Cardinals last week. They had 4 offensive linemen out. Quentin Nelson was not in the game. Quentin Nelson's a game changer. He's making offensive line great again. Now offensive line's always been great. I was an offensive lineman. I used to be 300 pounds. Might be a little hard to believe by this. I'm up 200 now. But anyways, Colts beat up the Cardinals and they were plagued by COVID-19. I don't think the Raiders are that good. Do the Raiders play good defense? Do they have a good rush defense? Yes, they do. But the Raiders have kind of skated into a position where they're able to make the playoffs right now. But I'll tell you what, the Indianapolis Colts at home, getting their guys back. Jonathan Taylor's a 100-yard rushing machine. So, hey, you take the ball, you take the ball, you get 100 yards. He's that good. He is that freaking good. That's why they're going to win this week. Quentin Nelson back, Jonathan Taylor, run the damn ball. Go Colts. Colts minus 6.5, easy money. Now, this is going to shift up to probably 7, by the way, when we get closer to kickoff. I get it at minus 6.5. It's too good of a deal. Jaguars-Patriots. I hate betting a minus 15.5 spread, but do the Jaguars really give me any choice? No, they don't. The Patriots have not played Bill Belichick football in the past few weeks. What are you going to do? It happens. They need to get back on track. This is the perfect get-right game for them, just like it was last week with Tampa Bay Buccaneers against Carolina Panthers. It was the perfect get-right game for Tom Brady. This is the perfect get-right game for Mac Jones against the Jacksonville Jaguars, who are not very good. They should come out there, should be able to establish the run, work the play action in there, and have a really good week. That's what I think. Patriots minus 15.5. I'm not taking the Jacksonville Jaguars. I'm not doing it. If you want to bet another good bet, take the under. I mean, Patriots run the ball. Jacksonville is not going to score a lot. I like the under. Buccaneers, Jets. Buccaneers minus 13.5 here. They're going to New York. Now, this game being in New York actually helps us as bettors. MetLife Stadium is not that intimidating, especially right now how the Jets are playing football. At minus 13.5, you got the hook. Get the 14. They got to win by 14. You got to win by 14. This line jumps up to 14.5. It's not as appealing. It's still appealing when we're talking Tampa Bay over the New York Jets. The Jets are not good at football. Now, as scary as this sounds, the Jets are slightly better than the Carolina Panthers. I will say that at this point in the season, I know Carolina beat them early in the year, but at this point in the season, I do think the Panthers are not as good as the Jets. So the Buccaneers might have a little more trouble than they did with Carolina. They might start a little slower than they did, but I still like them. Buccaneers minus 13.5. Easy money. That's the best team in football right now. Tom Brady's going to win another Super Bowl. Mark my words. Eagles, Washington. The Washington football team, they're not good. I mean, that what they showed against Dallas the other night was just embarrassing. I bet Dallas, but it made me feel sorry for anyone on the Washington football team. I mean, you got defensive linemen on the sidelines freaking fighting each other. Like, at that point, it was like, we get Tracy Morgan. Who's Nelson? I don't even know. Who's the guy that has the voiceovers? At this point, Washington bettors knew +10.5 wasn't going to hit. Who's that bet? Let me know in the comments. I don't know who I'm thinking of right now. But Washington football team, they're not good. They're playing the Eagles. I don't think the Eagles are great, but they're rolling right now. Jalen Hurts starting slow, getting better and better every week. I do like the Eagles at -4. Rams-Ravens. Someone let me know who that was. I was thinking of the comments. You know who it is. Rams-Ravens. The Rams were -3.5 last week against Minnesota. Now they took care of business. -3.5. They're going to do it again. The Ravens were spanked by Cincinnati last week. Absolutely spanked by Cincinnati. So when I factor this into the equation here, I'm going to go with the Rams. -3.5 last week against Minnesota. Easy money right now. They make it happen. Rams -3.5. Broncos, Chargers here. I hate betting on the Chargers. We know I hate betting on the Chargers. At -5.5 though, it's a good deal. It's a good deal this week, especially against the Broncos. Broncos play good defense, obviously, but they don't have Teddy Bridgewater. I don't think they're going to be able to put points on the board. We know how that's going to go. I like the Chargers at 5.5. I think Justin Herbert bounced back, and they have a pretty good day scoring points. Texans 49ers now. Texans pull the upset of the century, as I said, beating the Chargers. They were up like +500. The line opened for money line. That's pretty damn good for bettors that took a chance on the Texans. Now, the 49ers said last week after they got beat by the Tennessee Titans, I forget what player it was, but one of them said, hey, this is the best case scenario for us. This is best case scenario. I'm like, why? Because we have to win now. Okay, let's see it. 49ers -12.5. Let's see if you can actually go out and win. Let's see it. Cardinals, Cowboys. Now, the Cardinals have fallen apart, but here's the thing. They're still a reputable football team. As much as we want to write them off, they are still reputable. But good teams win. Great teams cover. Good teams win. Great teams cover. Dallas Cowboys. Good teams win. Great teams cover. Dallas Cowboys against spread are 12-3 this year. Cardinals have lost 3 straight games. Dallas Cowboys -5, baby. Rock and roll. Panthers, Saints now. We look at Panthers. We look at the Saints. The Saints need to get a quarterback back because what's his name from Notre Dame was not very good the other night. Carolina's not good at football, though. Cam Newton cannot throw. I could throw better than Cam Newton. I mean, look at these guns. Anyways, Carolina is so bad at football, it's not even funny. Saints -6.5. Rock and roll. I love this bet. I'm going to take it, even though the Saints still don't impress me that much. Yeah, they shut out Tom Brady a few weeks ago. What a blah, blah, blah. Nobody cares. All right, Lions-Seahawks. Lions are great against the spread. Tim Boyle, shout out Tim Boyle, went to my high school, played football with him, actually led our team to a state championship. He's 2-0 against the spread. Now, if they get Jared Goff back, I'm going to take this. If they don't get Jared Goff, I'm going to take this because Tim Boyle's 2-0 against the spread. Lions +7, easy money. Easy money. Lock it up. Seahawks, I'm done with the Seahawks. They embarrassed me last week. Vikings versus Packers. Green Bay Packers have struggled to cover in the past few weeks. But they are still very good against the spread. Just haven't been great in the past few weeks. Yet, I'm taking them this week because Minnesota's defense is not good. Minnesota's defense cannot hang in there with the Packers. Oh, Tanner, Minnesota beat Green Bay already this year. It's tough to beat a team twice, as we know. And I think Green Bay is rolling. As long as Aaron Rodgers doesn't get like sued by the league for talking out against the vaccine, because you never know what's going to happen. As long as Aaron Rodgers is back there playing quarterback, I will take the Green Bay Packers at -6.5 this week. Lock it up. And then finally, Monday Night Football, Browns, Steelers hand the ball to Nick Chubb. The Browns will cover. They will win by 3 points. The Steelers should be embarrassed. They should be embarrassed what happened to them last week against the Chiefs. Nick Chubb just needs to pound the rock. Pound the rock, pound the rock, pound the rock. Browns cover, easy money. Let's go to work. All right, that's the day. That's the show. Merch is coming. I forgot to talk about this at the beginning. Merch is coming. We're getting it. It's coming. I've talked to people. I've talked to the higher-ups. It's going to happen. B Parlay Army shirts are coming. Hammer the subscribe button. follow me on social at Tanner Curran on IG, at Tanner Curran underscore on Twitter. This is the Electric Factory. This is a group of bettors who are just going to war every day against the sportsbook. Going to war to win money every single day of the week. It's us versus the sportsbook. And you know who's going to come out on top? The bparlay army, baby. 12-4 against spread in week 16. Number 11 ranked NFL bettor on Sharp Rank. Check me out on there. And remember, you can watch me, mock me, try to block me, but you cannot stop me, Jordan freaking Belfort. Let's go win some money this week, baby. Week 17.